All right, let's see. Medical. Exum, Timmy, Kyrie all went through practice. Grant, right knee soreness, did not practice. Josh and Maxi did not practice. That's all I got.
Is there any further, some kind of update on Maxi in terms of what he's able to do or not able to do at this point?
No, there's no new updates. He's working in the weight room, and he's been on the court for spot shooting, but that's it.
No running.
No running, no.
Does Josh, could that potentially be a longer term?
Yeah, that I don't know. All I know, he didn't practice. And got treatment today, and I think we'll have more information tomorrow.
Kyrie looked good.
Yeah, Kyrie was fine. Went through everything today. He was good.
Obviously, Lawson got an opportunity the other night.
Yeah.
Looks like he's probably going to get more opportunities here.
Yeah, with the health situation, we kept him up with us, and so we'll see how our health goes. But if not, he will get a chance if guys are out.
What does he bring to you guys?
Well, I think just understand his toughness, his ability to score, shoot, and then on the defensive end, he competes. He's out there to try. He's trying to do the right things all the time, and that's a big thing. He was a big part of that comeback the other night.
He's been in the program now for a bit.
Yeah.
Do you see strides that he's making here and there and places?
Yeah, I think one, he's played it well into the G League, but two, he's been in the program. And so I think it just shows, and it's a compliment to him being able to be ready the other night. And then the way that he performed was, he was a big part of the comeback. And so understanding if guys aren't playing well, we have that opportunity to be able to play him. Just like we tried everybody the other night, he was the one that was going.
Obviously, it wasn't the result that you wanted at the end of the game against Oklahoma City, but what did you learn about your team going on a 30-0 run to be able to get back into that game?
Yeah, I think just the energy at halftime and throughout the third and fourth, guys to stay together. The character of that group was stayed together. Felt our leader in Luka was out there telling guys we have a chance, we can win this. We were down 21, we got it down to 9, and then went back to 21. But I think it all started with Luka's just confidence of just talking to the guys that are on the floor, just take one possession at a time. But the character of the group to fight all the way back, unfortunately it didn't go the way we wanted, but it was better than the 24 hours beforehand against Memphis. There was fight and energy, and that's what we talked about before the game.
You ever seen a 30-0 run before?
That was my first. And then it's impressive, very impressive.
That's the kind of thing you might see in youth league or something like that, not an NBA game.
Yeah, I don't know if it's ever been done, but it shows that we can play defense, and also we took care of the ball. A lot of guys were, it all starts with Luka, but a lot of guys benefited from the double teams and did the right thing.
You say it shows we can play defense. I mean, it did show that.
It did.
So are you asking yourself or asking the team why you don't see that a little more consistently?
Yeah, I think we've talked about it being consistent with the defense. We've shown that we can do it at times. It's just a matter of being consistent, and hopefully this week gives us that opportunity to be consistent on the defensive end as much as being consistent on the offensive end. But injuries here of late have put us in a different situation of new guys, playing a little bit more minutes. But I think those guys have also shown with that run that they can play defense.
From a communication standpoint, when you're trying to increase that consistency, how do you get that message across to ensure that the guys are getting the message based on what you're asking them to do every day?
Yeah, simple. It's just communication and showing them on the floor and also in the video room of being consistent. But the game of basketball is built on mistakes, and it's just limiting the mistakes. I thought we did that the other night, and then capitalizing on the mistakes, and we did that. So if we can be consistent in that area, it'll put us in a position hopefully to win some games.
Going back to Luka, one thing he's doing this year, he's shooting more threes but maintaining consistency. Is there anything you can pinpoint for that reason?
Yeah, he's one of the best in the world. works on his game, catch and shoot threes, off the dribble threes, his ability to get to the basket and make plays for others. And again, I think we all think that he just wakes up and does it, but he works extremely hard on his game and it's paying off right now.
Thank you, guys.
Have a good one.
So you find yourself on the court at the end of the game the other night, showing no fearlessness. Where did that come from? I mean, to basically kind of be out of the picture and then all of a sudden being there in crunch time.
I mean, just all the work that I put in this summer, throughout the season, you know, one thing that the coaches always say, stay ready. And like, I played out the one moment right there, stay ready. I came in, brought the energy, and like, I didn't even know we went on that big of a run, but that was a crazy run right there. Yeah.
When did you figure out that it was a 30-0 run?
After the game. I didn't really realize, because I was just so locked in. Like, I was going for next play. I was just so, like, you know, locked in with my teammates trying to win that the run just came automatically. I wasn't even thinking about that.
So when you found out it was a 30-0 run, just like, wow.
No, I was definitely shocked. I was like, oh, wow. Like, that's history for real. So it was a great feeling.
What's it been like for you this year? I mean, you're developing in the G League, but also now obviously getting lots of chances up here.
I mean, it was an amazing feeling. I felt truly blessed, especially after that game. Like, I went back home and realized, like, you know, like, anything's possible, like, with God. And, you know, I went home, talked to my parents, talked to my family, you know, just prayed and was very thankful and humbled.
Kind of going off that, watching guys like Luka, watching guys like Kyrie, how has that helped your development?
I mean, it helped a lot. You know, those guys are great players. That watch them every day in practice, seeing what they can do, and then learning them by guarding them. You know, when you guard one of the best players, you're automatically going to adjust and learn and learn different techniques. So I feel like it definitely got me better for sure.
Mm-hmm. What goes into the mindset of keeping yourself ready when you're looking for those opportunities and then being able to capitalize on those when you do get them?
I feel like just patience, you know, just waiting for your time, just being ready. I just say, for me, meditating before the game helped a lot too, and then I also went to chapel, got my mind right, and you know, God gave me the strength to go out there and, you know, try to help my team win. Even though we didn't get the win, I just feel like just that experience itself gave me a lot, like, to learn from.
How much does having been in this system now, Jason's, for a little bit, and you know, things that maybe at the start you had to process and think about, now just second nature?
I mean, just going on my second season with the Mavs now, like, I have a lot of confidence, like, with, like, the stats, defensively and offensively. I feel like when I'm on that court, I can talk more, be more confident in myself, and be, you know, just help the team out there, not be, like, you know, a downfall. Just try to uplift the team energy and just, like, just being me, doing all the right things.
For those of us who don't watch the Legends on a regular basis, yeah. Are you guys running the same offensive and defensive systems as the Mavericks?
Yeah, we follow the same type of schemes the Mavericks do. I feel like we play a little bit faster with the Legends because we got, you know, smaller guys. But yeah, definitely the same schemes. We try to implement the same thing. So it's definitely always help going down there and playing with them too.
Mm-hmm. Who's been the one guy, one team that's encouraged you most as you continue your journey to help you get those opportunities in this way?
I feel like a lot of guys on the team, you know, you got a good vets. I feel like Marquise helps a lot with me, Timmy. I mean, on the court for the last game, Luka was talking to me a whole lot, giving me confidence. So, you know, all the guys have their way of showing their love and helping out.
Appreciate it.
For sure, appreciate it.
Guess we'll be seeing a lot of you.
Hope so.